Welcome back. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at creating a basic workflow. And instead of showing you all the options that are available, I'm really just going to go over some of the key ones that you need to know to create the workflow. And then in the second part of this lesson, we'll start adding on additional layers to understand how these workflows work. So let's get into this. So to create a workflow, we go up to customization, and then we have this workflows tab, and we can click on this to show a list of all the workflows we have, but we're gonna create a new one. So we come to this page, and first off, you do have the option to go to template, and we have a few options here that come with our NetSuite edition that we can use as basic templates for creating a workflow. So if you see one here that fits one of your requirements, by all means, use it. But for the sake of this video, we're gonna create a workflow from scratch. So you'll see here, we've got a lot of different options. Again, I'm just gonna fill in the things that you have to. So let's mock up a scenario here. Let's say we want to take, I've got a sales order over here. We wanna have for sales orders, the billing payment method. We want it to default, right now it's blank, but we want that payment method field to default to a certain value. So we're gonna set up a workflow that's an automation, and automatically when a sales order is generated or edited, we're gonna have it default to a certain payment method. So let's get into this. We're gonna call, first we have to name the workflow. So let's say default payment method. And obviously we can put in ID, etc. I'm gonna leave that blank for now. Record type, so we need to specify, well, what kind of record are we dealing with? So we are dealing with a transaction record, as opposed to maybe a customer or some other type of record. And as soon as we specify that record type, we have all these subtypes that we can choose from. And it's a multiple choice. We can select many different types if we want to, and the workflow would apply to every type. But in this case, we're just gonna do a sales order. So I'm gonna click on that. And the description, you should always put in description so it's easy for you or another person to understand just at a glance what that workflow is doing. So we're gonna say default the preferred payment method. Okay, so it has our owner. So a lot of these things I'm not going to get into, but I am gonna specify release status. So we have four different options here. And really what this is doing is specifying that when we create this workflow, how much is it gonna interact with our system? What is it gonna do as soon as we save it and create that thing? So first off, we have released. We're gonna go bottom to top. Released means the second we save it, it's in action. It's now executing things in our NetSuite instance. Testing specifies that it will only interact with whoever the creator is. In this case, you, the person that's creating this workflow, you can test certain transactions through it. And I'll get into that in a later video, but the concept is just, if you're still testing out with the thing and you want to be able to have it only interact with you, you can set it to testing. Not initiating is saying that new sales orders won't necessarily interact with this workflow, but if any past sales orders have already gone through the workflow, those will remain as is. And then lastly, we have suspended, which means that any sales order, whether it's interacted with it in the past or it's being generated newly, won't have anything to do with this workflow. So in this case, I am gonna click released. In this particular case, I am in a demo account, so basically like a sandbox. If you're going to have released as the status, you do want to work in a sandbox account. And again, I'll get more into this in a later video, but for this standpoint, do not, in a live production account, do not set it to released, because putting in a workflow, especially that's not properly set up, can create havoc. So you don't want to mess around with that. Just use another state or be operating with it in a sandbox account. So for our use in this demo account, released is okay. And then again, I'm gonna get into some of these other options later, but for now, I'm simply going to add on create, which means as soon as the sales order is created, this workflow will apply to it. And with that in mind, again, I have a lot of options here. I'm actually not gonna get into them. I'm simply going to hit save. So here we have this main area. This is kind of like a whiteboard where we're gonna be creating our workflow. And then on the right, we have a panel that's gonna give us information regarding what we're looking at. And I'm not gonna go too much into this, but understand that everything I'm gonna be interacting with here and these various pop-up windows that I'm gonna be pulling up, a lot of that you will have the option to do the same thing over on the right here. For example, you have these pencils that can do edits over there as opposed to clicking in the workflow area as I will be doing in these videos. So we have this state here, and notice we come in at the top and then we have the state and then we end here at the bottom. And the way to think about this is that basically in these states or these boxes, some action is going to occur that will dictate what is going to be changing behind the scenes in NetSuite. And it's a little easier to understand or visualize if we create several of these. So let's just set this up here. And you can understand that we're in state one, and state one can go to state two or not go to state two. And then maybe state two can go to state three or four. So as you're moving along, it's almost like a true false. Is it state one? Is it true that it's gonna go to state two? Okay, if it does, at state two, is it gonna go to state three or state four? So a lot of what I'm gonna be showing you in these workflows really is that kind of A or B example. And it really, is the ball gonna be pushed forward one more stage? And if it does, does it go to here or go to there? Most cases, it's two options, but in a lot of cases, you will have multiple options. There could be five different other states that it then progresses on from. So it really just depends how you set that workflow up. For this first example, I'm just gonna show you with one state. So we're gonna get rid of these. I'll hit okay. And we've got this one state. So the first thing we're gonna do is double click on this. And it pulls up the workflow state and has the ability to edit it. Again, if that panel on the right, if you click the pencil, you can also do a similar thing. The first thing we're gonna do is just name this thing. So preferred payment method. And it's good to also add a description. I'm not gonna add a description in every instance for the sake of this video, but you should add them so it's clear when other people are coming onto this, exactly what's happening. But the first thing you have to set is the name here. And then what I'm gonna do is hit save. The reason for that is because I'm gonna double click this again. You have to save the state first. So once you set the name, you hit save before you're able to start adding a bunch of additional things. So you kind of have to have this two-step process where you save what you're gonna call it and you can put the description in there and then you come back and then you can start adding actions. So this new action, that's gonna be the bread and butter of what you're gonna be doing with these workflows or these states in this particular example. So let's add an action. And again, you're gonna see a lot of options here, but I'm just gonna cover the absolute basics. So what we wanna do is for the payment method, we wanna specify that that payment method is, and let's say it's gonna be MasterCard. So we're gonna set it as that. So out of all these options, really what it's saying is, what are, of the many different action types that we can do, what are we going with? So what we're trying to accomplish is called set field value. So we can see down here, set field value, we're gonna click on that. And it's gonna bring us to this page or this pop-up window. Again, a lot of different options here. We'll cover this in the next video, but for this exact usage, we're actually gonna skip a lot of these top options here. And the way you can think about all of these top options, as well as it goes down quite a bit. So everything here in this top section, even though funny enough, they name the bottom section as parameters, I think it's better to think of the whole top section as really the parameters of what are you dealing with? You know, what is this thing at all? What is it gonna affect and when is it gonna affect that thing? So you're really setting these parameters of how much is this action gonna influence. For this standpoint, there's certain defaults that come set that we're just gonna leave it as is and we're gonna specify what the action is actually doing. So down here in parameters, we can set what is this field that we're interacting with. So if we go back to the sales order, we have this payment method field. That's the one that we want to default to a certain value. So if we go back up here, so we're gonna click on this field and we're gonna select that field that we wanna change, which is payment method. Once we've selected that field, now we're gonna dictate what are we changing it to. So you have a few options. We're just gonna go with static value, again, for this very simple example. So we go to static value and then we have this little option here. We can select what the static value is. So we click on that and it'll give us a list of possible values. So as gone over before, let's say we wanna choose MasterCard. So we've selected MasterCard. And now without doing anything else, I'm gonna hit save. Okay, good. So now you can see down here, we now have, that wasn't there before, we now have this action that's listed there in the bottom. And a lot of workflows will have many actions, so you'll see them listed out, and you can even click on them, and you'll be able to, as there's many actions, you can move them around so you have certain actions occur before other actions. But those are the basics. We're not gonna go any deeper than that for this particular first example. We're gonna hit save. We go okay. So we've now created a single state workflow. And because earlier I specified that this workflow is on released because I'm in a demo account, just the fact that I've saved it now, it is now in action. So let's actually go to this sales order and we're gonna refresh. Notice it's blank here. We're gonna refresh this sales order. Okay, so we have the exact same sales order pull up, but now as we go down and we go back to billing, payment method is now MasterCard. So we've, because of our workflow, we've managed to replace a default value in a field to whatever we want it. Now, in the next video, we're gonna add some additional parameters. We're gonna start looking at all of those fields that I was skipping to understand some of the additional capability we have with these workflows. So I'll see you in that video.